That's the bladder. It's right in front of the uterus. You can pass that around. This is your uterus. That's why I said, now this is a real life depiction of how it actually looks.
Mm-hmm. And see how small the uterus is? It's not big at all.
The baby is in there.
You think the uterus is big. It's not. About 2 inches, 3 inches.
Wow. Wait a minute.
And this is called the pelvic belt. And this is the sigmoid.
The bladder.
That's the bladder.
And so,
that's
the sigmoid.
This is what, the kidney?
This is the uterus, the actual.
Go and put it in there for him, Monica. Show him out there.
There we go. You see it? Got the inside of the uterus.
So is the cervix there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The cervix. Actually, this is the vaginal canal. Okay. The cervix would be
up and right
at the bottom.
Right in there.
Where is that at again? Mm-hmm.
At the, so it would be right here.
Right here?
The mouth of the cervix.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And this is the vaginal opening, right here. So this is the canal.
Oh, that's okay,
That's
what they're tightening over there. That's
exactly correct. So
that lingam going there. Yeah.
And the babies roll out of there.
Yeah. So, as you can see, we're going to go ahead and put our uterus back in here.
Yeah, put it back together.
Put it back in.
To keep it tight.
So you have the vagina, you know, the vaginal canal, and then you have the uterus. And you all saw the fallopian tubes as well as the ovaries.
So, question, when they do a hysterectomy, just curious, did it take out the whole uterus?
Well, some people
you get partial
because you have to remember these are tendons as well. Mm-hmm. So sometimes they just cut the uterus and leave the fallopian tubes.
Okay.
That's why you'll hear some women saying, "Well, I."